This is the testing setup for the low-level drug and storage system of RBS. I will use this voltage supply as an alternator, which can supply a 12-volt voltage for the capacitor. The voltage from this power supply will charge into these parallel branches of the capacitor, and when this capacitor full, they will stack together to put these two branches in series to double the voltage, and the voltage of the whole capacitor system will boost either to 48 volt to accelerate the vehicle, or boost to 50 volt to charge into the battery. This voltmeter will monitor the voltage of the capacitor. This voltmeter will monitor the voltage of 48 volt, and the other voltmeter will monitor the voltage of 50 volt. On this oscilloscope, the yellow channel monitor the gate of the low side switch, and the second channel, the blue channel, will monitor the gate of the high side switch. When both these channels pull up, that means the low side switch turn on and the high side switch turn off. And when these two channels pull down, that means the low side switch turn off and the high side switch turn on. The pin channel, the third channel, will monitor the voltage of the capacitor. To discharge the voltage from the capacitor, I will use the electronic load to discharge it, and I set the discharging current 3 amps. And now, when I turn on this power supply, the current of 20 amps will charge into these parallel branches of the capacitor, and you will see the voltage of the capacitor increase around 12 volt. That means the capacitor full, and you will see it stacked together. Yeah, these parallel branches of the capacitor stack together, double the voltage, and you will see the low side switch turn off and the high side switch turn on. When I still and right away, when this voltage double, it will go through the boost up this voltage to 48 volt and ready to accelerate the vehicle. If I still apply 12 volt into the input, that means when we still apply the brake, or 12 volt from the alternator still go into the capacitor, the voltage of the capacitor will boost up to 50 volt to charge into the battery. And now, if I turn off the power supply, that means no more voltage from the alternator to the capacitor. So you will see no more 50 voltage to charge into the battery bank. And now, when I turn on the load, the voltage from the capacitor will discharge through 48 volt, boost, and you will see the voltage of the capacitor will drop down. And now I will turn on the load, and you will see the voltage will drop down about 40% and around 30%, and this capacitor will separate and to put back in parallel for the next generation, for the next charging cycle. So now I will let this system charge and discharge automatically. Now I will turn on the power supply to supply some voltage to charge into the capacitor, and I also turn on the load to discharge the capacitor. You will see voltage of the capacitor double, and now it discharge at 3 amp. The voltage of the capacitor go down around 30 volt, and it will unstuck. That means it's put in parallel and continue to charge the capacitor until full, and they stuck together to double the voltage and discharge through the boost 48 volt or 51 volt. It will discharge to the battery bank if I still apply 12 volt in here. And you see, I finished the whole test. I finished the testing for the whole system, and this system works very well, perfectly. If we can have a constant voltage from the alternator to charge into the capacitor.